researchers pinpoint most likely source of HIV rebound infection. In findings that have implications for potential new HIV therapies, researchers from Texas Biomedical Research Institute used genetic sequencing techniques on simian immunodeficiency virus, SIV, to identify that lymph nodes in the abdomen are the leading source of rebound infection after the first week of stopping antiretroviral therapy. Lymphoid tissues are known to be large reservoirs of latent HIV, said Texas Biomedical Professor Binhua Julie Ling, MD, PhD, and a senior paper author, and perhaps the source of initial viral rebound, she added. Now, we have evidence that SIV, and therefore potentially HIV, is hiding in specific types of lymph nodes and spleen tissues and is some of the first to reemerge in blood when treatment is stopped. ART does an excellent job at suppressing HIV to undetectable levels in the blood. However, small amounts of latent virus hide throughout the body, including in the brain, lungs, gut, spleen, lymph nodes, and other organs. Stopping treatment opens the door for the virus to rebound. If we can identify the starting point of the virus rebound, we can work on developing treatments that target those tissues and stop the virus from spreading in the first place, Dr. Ling said. Dr. Ling and her team teamed up with Brandon Keel, PhD, in the AIDS and Cancer Virus Program at Frederick National Laboratory, in Maryland, who generated barcode viruses. More than 9,000 individual viruses in the stock have unique genetic barcodes, similar to those used in grocery stores. Those barcode viruses were given to 7 non-human primates. After infection was established, the primates began receiving ART. After 4 to 6 months on ART, the animals had either very small viral loads or no detectable virus circulating in blood, much like people living with HIV who are on ART. When treatment was stopped after more than a year of ART, researchers were able to assess the very earliest stages of viral rebound. Thanks to the barcode viruses, they could identify in which tissues the virus had replicated the fastest and spread the furthest just 7 days after treatment was stopped. They matched the barcodes most prevalent in blood plasma to the barcodes detected in specific tissues. Of note, the standard test did not detect any virus in blood at the 7-day mark, but more sensitive deep sequencing did. The researchers found 3 leading contributors: mesenteric lymph nodes, which are found in the tissue connecting the intestines to the abdominal wall; the spleen, which is a part of the lymphatic system that filters blood; and inguinal lymph nodes, which are in the groin. Through additional analyses, the researchers found CD4 T cells in the mesenteric lymph nodes and spleen had higher amounts of intact virus and replication activity, which corresponded with higher rates of barcode viruses from those regions in blood plasma. This was further confirmed using a novel technology by Qingxing Li, PhD, at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. Of interest, some animals showed no evidence of viral rebound, indicating they had better control of the virus in the first week after treatment was stopped than others, through single-cell sequencing and transcriptomic analyses. The team identified a few genes of interest that contribute to dysregulation of normal cell function and could play a role in the differences between animals who experienced very rapid rebound and the animals who continued to suppress viral activity. The researchers acknowledged that the study size of 7 animals is small, and that tissue sample size was also limited. Nonetheless, the results point to key organs to explore. With more than 800 lymph nodes in the body, knowing which to target could lead to more tailored treatments faster, they said.